Welding. Welding is the joining process in which two metals part together to give a sound and strong joint with the help of the weld pool, and we will allow the weld pool to get solidified. For example, I am having one part here, another part here. These parts, with the help of some external material called as filler rod, we will try to make a weld pool creation, so that that particular part is going to be termed as a bead, and this is called as a welded joint. And filler metal will be used to effect the union. So it welding process consisting of two types. One is a fusion welding. So in this fusion welding, it involves heating the ends of the metal pieces to be joined at a temperature which is close enough to cause them or to melt or and allow them to join to cool, and means we are allowing them to get solidification. And this process is very similar to the casting process. Instead of molten metal melting there, we are trying to create the weld pool in the form of a molten metal. Thus, the joint after the fusion metal has solidified will result as a strong joint. And the next one is a pressure welding. So this pressure welding involves heating the ends of the metal pieces which are to be joined at a high temperature but lower than the melting point, and then keeping the metal pieces joined together under pressure for some time. This results the pieces welding together to produce a strongest joint. These are two categories of welding. Next, types of welding process. If you observe the welding process, the basic welding process is classified as pressured welding and non-pressure welding. As I can say that pressure welding and fusion welding. Fusion welding. In this fusion welding, we are having gas welding, electric arc and unshielded arc. In this gas, we are having three categories: oxy-acetylene, oxy-hydrogen and oxy-benzene. Electric arc is having a classification of shielded arc material. In this shielded arc, we are having gas shielded arc. In this gas, we are having atomic, argon, tungsten, metal, inert gas. So these are some major categories of welding process for different applications. And unshielded arc, we will have metal arc, carbon arc and tungsten arc. Coming to the pressurized welding, and this is this pressurized welding is going to be heat is going to be produced due to the pressure, and we can term it as blacksmith's fire. In this one, we can say lap joint, butt joint, V joint and T welding joint. With the help of electric current, we will get a spot welding, seam welding, projection welding, butt welding, percussion welding also, this resistance welding also. And from this projection welding, we have two classifications: diffusion welding, ultrasonic and electro beam welding. Apart from this one, we can able to do by using the chemical reaction. This is called as a thermal welding or thermit process. Thermit process. This thermit welding is majorly used in rails welding. Okay, in railways, if you observe, rail is going on a track. That track we are going to term it as a rails. So this rails welding, this thermit welding is going to be used. So these are the various classification of welding process. Next, gas welding process. So gas welding process consisting of a glass flame which is going to use to raise the temperature of the metals which is going to be joined. It consisting of a base metal and it consisting of a filler rod. It also consisting of a welding torch tip. So welding torch tip, filler rod, base metal relatively move along one point to another point on the base metal, so that this welding torch release some kind of a flames, and this filler rod get melted. It is getting deposited on the base metal, so that the base metal will try to have a bonding with the two base metals. And here it is acetylene and oxygen gas. The metal flows and cooling it solidifies. Molten metal may be added to flowing molten metal to fill up the cavity made during the end of the preparation. Here there are multiple combinations of the gas are used in the gas welding. As we have discussed earlier, we are having oxyacetylene also. Most common thing they are using oxygen and acetylene gas. So oxyacetylene welding. So this oxyacetylene welding have a heat source of combustion of acetylene gas, which is going to produce a temperature at 3250 degrees Celsius to melt the most of metals and alloys. And it is classified as two systems, high pressure system. In this high pressure system, both oxygen and acetylene gases are drawn from the cylinders with these gases which are stored at high pressure. Whereas in low pressure system, oxygen gas is drawn from a cylinder as before, but acetylene is produced at a low pressure. Acetylene gas is produced in a sealed container in which water falls drop by drop on calcium carbide. This acetylene gas is going to be drawn from oxyacetylene welding as per the requirement. So these are the two classifications of high pressure and low pressure. Then coming to the tools, or what are the equipment used in welding, oxyacetylene welding. If you observe this one, there are two cylinders. One is oxygen cylinder, the other one is acetylene cylinder. One will be of black color, one will be of maroon red color. Oxygen will be black, acetylene will be in maroon red color. Here you can able to see, for both the cylinders you can see one valve as well as one regulator and pressure gauges also. So as we are seeing from the welding equipment, oxygen cylinder and acetylene cylinder, pressure gauges. So pressure gauges are used to control the pressure which are there in the cylinders, and we can able to see regulators also, pressure regulators. So these are the pressure regulators which we can able to see here. Okay, and the next one is a hose pipes. Hose pipes are the pipes which are going to, this black lines are there, these are the hose pipes. These pipes are going to transfer the oxygen from the cylinder to the torch pipe. This torch pipe is also called as blow pipe. Okay, the other name for the torch pipe is blow pipe. So torch pipe, the advantage of the torch pipe is this acetylene gas and oxygen gas, both the things they are getting combined, and a flame is generating from the outer surface of the torch. So this is the torch. From the outer surface of the torch we are getting a flame, and the welding tip is end point of the torch. This is the welding tip. And the next one is a valves. Valves are used to control the airflow from the cylinder to the hose pipe. Next one is goggles. So goggles are used to place on the eyes, because a high heat source will be available here, it may destroy the eyes. So to protect our eyes, we are trying to use goggles. Next, working principle. Working principle is very easy, because here we can say that hot flames are going to be produced and burning of gases comes through the tip. Here the filler metal is going to be added. When the molten metal mixture on cooling forms a welding joint, and this welding joint is going to, we are allowing some time to get it solidified so that we will get a joint. And here oxygen cylinder and acetylene cylinder are filled with gases. These cylinders are attached with pressure gauges, regulators and cylinder valves, as we have discussed in the earlier case. The cylinder containing the oxygen is painted with black, whereas the acetylene is painted with maroon red. Hose pipes are also provided to the each cylinder. These pipes are connected to with a welding torch. So flames. So we are saying that oxygen and acetylene are going to be mixed. So here a chemical reaction is going to be takes place like this. 2H2 plus 5O2 gives rise to 4 carbon dioxide plus 2H2O. So the first one is a neutral flame. In this neutral flame, the ratio of oxygen to acetylene in the mixture leaving the torcher is almost equal to 1:1, like 1:1 ratio we are going to be supply. And these are this neutral flame is used only for welding steel and cast irons. If you observe this one, this is the neutral flame. So this is the welding tip and the torch is this one. From the welding tip you can see inner core, this is inner core and this one is outer core. So outer core, okay. So the inner core temperatures will be 3400 degrees centigrade, whereas the outer core temperature will be 1300 degrees centigrade. Here it is blue, here light blue, here it is dark orange mixed blue also. Next, oxidizing flame. So in this oxidizing flame, the volume of oxygen gas is more than the volume of acetylene which is mixed in the torch. And this is used for welding of brass and also used for cutting of various metals. And here the inner core temperature will be 3500 degrees centigrade. So this particular points are going to ask in multiple number of examinations, like what is the inner core of the neutral flame, what is the inner core temperature of the oxidizing flame, and carburizing flame. So carburizing flame is when the volume of acetylene is mixed more than the oxygen. Whenever it is oxidation, more oxygen. Whenever it is carbon dioxide, more acetylene. And this flame is used for welding of nickel, monel, which are difficult to cut materials. Okay, difficult to cut materials. There we are trying to use this carbonizing flame. And here the inner core temperature is 3150 degrees centigrade.